To start up the Cobalt desk, push the power button in the top right-hand side of the screen. When we first start up our Cobalt, we'll see the Welcome to Cobalt screen. There are a couple of important parts here. First off, we have the Start Offline, Start Server, and System Settings commands. If the desk is part of a multi-console setup, you'll also have the option to start client in between Start Offline and Start Server. If we start offline, we'll have all of our normal Cobalt functions, but no data will actually leave the desk. If you select Start Server, it'll start into Cobalt normally. If we navigate over to Power Off and hit Modify, it'll shut down our console. Take a look in the top right-hand corner and notice you have some information about our console. It's showing us the primary IP address of the console and which Ethernet-based protocols are being used. In the center of the screen, down near the bottom, you'll notice the software version that this console is running. If we navigate using our arrow keys over to System Settings and hit Modify, this will open the System Settings screen. Inside of System Settings, we have a number of features we can customize for the console. For the most part, you'll only have to do this once when you first take the console out of the box, but some things you'll change a little bit more often. Underneath the General tab, we have the ability to name the console, to set the current date and time, to change the time zone, set your preferred language, and your preferred keyboard. If you go over to the Network tab, you find the ability to customize your network settings, including IP address, subnet, and gateway, and the ability to define which output protocols are being used and set some priority information for each one. If you're using a DHCP server, you have the ability to customize that here. On the Monitor tab, you have the Monitor Arrangement option. This allows us to move our monitors around and set up our space so it represents exactly what's going on with our physical monitors. We also have the ability to identify, configure, and calibrate touchscreens here. Underneath the Update tab, this is where we're going to be able to update our software, and if we purchase an upgrade code, install that. Software updates can be downloaded from ETC's website directly to a flash drive, brought to the console, and installed using this dialog. When we're done configuring our system settings, hit OK to return to the welcome screen. To start Cobalt normally, hit Start Server, and we're ready to begin. When we first start up our console, we're greeted by the System Start Options screen. This allows us to resume the last show we were working with, create a new show from the default, start a new show with a one-to-one patch, or start a new show with a no patch. At the top, we also have the ability to navigate over to open a different show file than the last one we're working with. Inside of this, we have the ability to select where we want to open it from, Play Archive, which is our name for hard drive, or a flash drive. Underneath that, the different folders we may have stored on our hard drive. And then finally, the file itself. If we're going to start with a new patch, we can come down, select no patch or one-to-one, your preference, and hit Modify. This is the Let's Begin screen. It allows us to customize some basic system settings that we'll be using throughout our play. Things like default times for go, in, and out are found here. Once we're done with these settings, hit Modify, and we're ready to start programming our show.